Hi, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Got a nice little classy motorhome to show you today. So you're taking a look here probably because you're interested in a Class C, this type of a format. This is a great coach if you're looking for something to be able to take your family out with and enjoy some good camping experience. It's good balance. This is a 27-foot motorhome. 27Q is the model number. Actually, it's going to be probably a little longer than 27 feet overall if we're going to measure it from one end to the other. But small enough to get in most of the places you like to go, and big enough to be comfortable when you're out in it. It's built on a Ford chassis. It has the E450. So it's powered by a Ford V10. It's got plenty of power to get you where you want to go. If you want to pull a boat behind it or a little car, you have enough suspension where you can do that without any trouble. Good little layout, just made by Winnebago. It's called the Mini Winnie. You know, for starters, I guess I'd like to point out too that Winnebago, on all their motorhomes, they use a one-piece fiberglass roof. So they don't use a rubber roof. Most of their application on some other manufacturers on their entry-level stuff, they'll use a fiberglass, or use a rubber roof rather than fiberglass because it's a little less expensive to build. So, point of information, whether it's entry level or high end with Winnebago, they use a one-piece fiberglass roof, which is has its real advantages. It's less likely to break down over a period of time. It weathers better, less, it's more resistant to poking a hole in it on down the line. So, good application, great motorhomes built very solidly. Take a look around the outside. Notice the size of the awning. It's got a nice big awning on this one. It's all electric too, by the way. So it's just a push button awning. A nice finish on the outside. This is a good quality finish. Nice high gloss, fiberglass. One of the things I think is really impressive about this floor plan too is the amount of storage back here. If you notice, down here, back here, you have access to pass-through storage. Which you can access from back in here from either side or the back. Nice little tub down here. It's all rotocast plastic. Even has little drain holes down here, so if you were to use this to throw ice in, maybe you wanted to have a little tailgate and ice, throw ice back in there and throw beverages in there, you could, or fish or whatever the case may be. The other thing that's really, I think, nice about Winnebago as a manufacturer, aside from the fact they've been around forever, everybody recognizes that name because they've been in business for a long time. You know, they started building motorhomes in the early 70s. They built trailers even before that, so they are a well-established manufacturer. But one of the things that I really like about this manufacturer is they're a true manufacturer. So they build a lot of their own motorhome themselves. So, for example, these rotocast storage bins down here, this is, they make their own storage tanks. They do their own doors, like everything that they build, they label. Like this particular door has a label on it, so if you ever need to replace it, we can just go to this and we know exactly what it came out of. They do some of their own metals, some of their steel they do, cabinets, they even build some of their own furniture. And you might ask, well, so what's the advantage for me? And really, it's two big advantages are, one, the quality is consistent because they build it. And the other thing is, if you ever need a replacement for something on down the road, because people keep motorhomes for a while, some people have them for many, many, many years, and you know, we've all heard the story about the manufacturer that went out of business and is no longer around, and you need a replacement part, and it's pretty tough to find. Or maybe the manufacturer's still in business, but they bought parts from Joe Blow and they're not around anymore, so it gets more complicated to try and keep your motorhome up if you ever need anything for it. Winnebago's been around, no reason to believe they won't continue to be around. Just one couple things on this side of the motorhome. This does have a nice little slide out, as you can see, with an awning. Adds to the livability in the coach. Let's take a walk through here, let's go inside. So it has a good layout. This one actually has, even though it's not a huge coach, it has sleeping for quite a few people. As you can see, it does have a bed up on top here. So once this all fills in, you've got a nice, let's see if we, I guess I've got this all fastened together, but you can kind of see this fills in right here. So you've got a nice big bed right there, a little ladder to get up and down. The cabin's easy to access. That's why they split the bed like this, so it makes it a little easier to get in and out of the front seats. Nicely equipped, has, you know, power windows, power locks, all the amenities. Nice little backup system. A nice dinette booth with storage down below. So these will actually, cushions will come up. I guess we got the seat belts all connected here, so it's not really wanting to cooperate very well. But you can see down there, there's plenty of storage, so you can put things down there that maybe you wouldn't use all the time, but a place to put something that you couldn't access otherwise. And again, you were talking about Winnebago making a lot of their own furniture. They even do their own cushions for their dinette. This is all built by Winnebago. Notice the flooring, easy to clean. It's a nice vinyl floor. Really, there's little, if any, carpet in here. I don't see any carpeting, actually. This is all going to be easy to clean. Nice kitchen area, has a pretty good size. Full extension drawers with nice metal glides. Little TV up front here. Storage up above. Double sink. Three burner cook stove with an oven and a microwave as well. This one is equipped with a holding tank heater, so if you do get out in the cold weather and you're might get into a situation where you got some freezing weather or it gets really cold, you can turn on the tank heater, keep the holding tank warm, keep from freezing over. Controls right here too for your generator. You can check all your tank levels, turn the water heater on right here, water pump, everything's easily accessible. Got a nice little set up here too for a pantry with sliding drawers to come out. It utilizes the space really well, in a way you can don't have to try and reach in there to get to your stuff. Slide control right there. Has a nice little bathroom. Sink, toilet, shower all in one with more storage in there as well. Two-door refrigerator. This is gas and electric too. It's not a residential style where it's only 110, so if you do dry camp, you can operate this off of propane, or if you're plugged in somewhere, you can run just off the 110 element. It does have a walk-around bed, which is very nice. You've got a queen-size bed, storage on both sides for cabinets that you can put. You can hang clothes on either side. Nice little nightstand over here with a nice little drawer. Again, more storage up above. And really try to utilize the space well in this motorhome. Again, that's a great size motorhome if you're looking for something that's not too big, but you know, gonna be able to fit everybody in the family comfortably. This could be the one. Brand new 2015. We're motivated to sell what we have. Dealership's been here since 1988 with the same owners since then. So we're here to take care of your RV needs. We've been here for the long run, plan on being here for a lot longer. So And my name again is Jim Beckler, so if you would ask for me, I'd appreciate it. You can reach me on my personal phone at 541-510-1017. So give me a call and I'd be glad to help. Thanks.